Hi guys, welcome to another battle. This time I have been in Berlin on a tournament, Gober Crown, and this was Masters tournament, and my first opponent was Menot, Protectorate of Menot with Severus II, and I took Striker to list because that's my direct counter to Menot. So my setup is pretty standard. I put lances on the left and right on both flanks, and battle group in the middle, and my storm blades skewed to the right side. I won the roll and I chose to go first, so we'll see how my opponent deployed, but the general idea is to push lances far forward, be ready to counter his advance, jam him probably out of scenario if possible, and then Stormblades will be the second wave attacking. So my opponent skews to his zone, more defensive formation, which is actually not so bad, because if he doesn't put enough forces into my zone, I will be able to clear it and start scoring with Striker. And Striker is somehow in the middle, just to react on to the deployment of my opponent. So Stormblades move the advance move, and I start my first turn. The staff runs, I run jacks as far as I can. My opponent doesn't have much shooting, except spells on Sevi 2. So Striker advances and velocities forward. And I cast Acceleration, because that will protect me a bit against the spells as well. And then left unit of lances gets Arcane Shield and runs forward. The right unit of lances also runs forward, but they will be only protected by deceleration. I make sure to stay in range of the deceleration. So Leathermore goes to the left flank. All the jacks are in the middle. They will, from here I can react with them in both sides. And Stormblades run now to the right flank. Although I probably should have run them more to the middle, and my support staff lags behind. And now it's my opponent's turn. What's good fighting against this protectorate list, the jacks are not very fast, they cannot be speed up too much or at all, so threat rangers are not very far, so I out-threat them, so I will do alpha, and my idea is that next round I will feed and hit them as hard as possible with two attacks, with regular attacks and then a feed attack. If I position my positive charge right, then I should have a good damage. So as you see, my opponent has a bit of a problem how to approach. Of course, nobody wants to tank an alpha, although Sevi 2 has oracular vision on his battle group, so all of his jacks will be able to ignore the first damage roll. So somewhere in the middle between all those jacks, there is this Sevi's Arknode, Blessing of Vengeance, and he is my first target. If my opponent will leave me opening and I will be able to remove him, I need to do it as fast as possible, or at very least engage him so he will not be able to cast spells. But this is always difficult, because with Oracular Vision he can walk away from combat and just use his oracular vision to be not get damaged by free strike. So the jacks start moving up. As you see, the blessing is hiding behind a heavy. Actually, my opponent did not have much choice. He had to get in forward. Staying out of my threat rangers would mean he would have to stay just behind his deployment zone. So that was not an option for him. So his large portion of his battle group goes to the to his zone, which I find very good for me, because even if I will not be able to destroy those jags, I can try to jam them in place, and they are pretty slow, so they will have a hard time getting into my zone in time. Important thing would be to just destroy the objective to increase scoring. So the Blessing of Vengeance, the Sevi casts Ash Hexblast on my lenses, removing my lens. I was expecting that, but I did give them Arcane Shield still, because Sevi has to spend 3 focus on Hexblast, so this is pretty expensive spell. And this means he can only then cast Ashes to Ashes once. So Sevi feeds in feast round. I lose one of my lenses, so not a high price to pay for his feet gone. So as suspected, the choir gives Jack's passage, and then his left flank advances. I'm very happy about the trouble in the middle, because only a single Jack is going directly toward my toward my zone, and the other one is going around the rubble, more into the middle, which is pretty good. So now I want to do my feet turn. I will try to jam him and put as much damage into him as possible. I consider now his trainers, would it be optimal maybe to stay out of them for another turn? So I advanced Aurowdy to be just outside of threat range of the most forward of his jacks. Aurowdy is for me more like a late game piece. And he's protecting a striker to the mid game, and most work in the feet round and in the beginning rounds is done by the lenses and the light jacks. And then the second wave is Aurowdy and Stormblades, and sometimes also Striker himself. So Arcane Shield goes this time to the lenses on the right, a big unit. So I charge in two of my lenses that were in range of the jack there, and the rest just takes positions outside of the threat ranges of the other jacks. So the jack gets hit. I hit him from outside of his threat range, but Jack has 11, so he advances into my threat range, so I cannot reposition away too much. So this this was a bit problematic for me, but we'll see. So I advance the Stormblade Captain. Now I created myself a bit of a jam, but the Striker advances, goes into the zone. He casts positive charge on, I believe, two Jacks, and the Lancer was first to run forward, and my Lancers charging. Two of them. And again, I do some damage to Blessing of Vengeance, I believe. There are some Electrolips going around. What I forgot to do, which was quite important, I forgot to feed with Striker. This is why I did not contribute Leathermore and the last lens, and this is why I right now put my Stormblades more to the middle. There will be a second wave of jamming though, all those heavies from Menoth. And that was my turn. So not much work done, just jammed a bit, but I have positioned my Leathermore and my last lens in a spot that I will be able to maybe kill the objective next round, and the next wave of my Stormblades will go into him, and there is a lot of stuff in the way, so maybe I will start scoring in his round in my zone, because the lenses and the house up there is blocking his way, and the rest of his army is pretty far back and is quite slow, so that would give me a head-on scenario if I can score this round 1 point, then destroy the objective and score once next round. I will be 3-0 maybe, and good ahead of scenario, and then just keep cleaning my zone for 2 rounds, and I will have a scenario win. Forgetting to feed was a big deal, but that means that I will be able to feed next round. So his jacks try to do some work, but Sevi keeps some focus to himself, but it's enough for them to clear my lenses to that were in front, and Sevi keeps his focus to clear the lenses on his left flank. So with the lenses that were engaging, the Blessing of Vengeance gone, he is free to go and be in range of my lenses to cast his spells. So another Jax goes in for the Lancer, but the Lancer is stubborn and surviving. Book goes or runs forward. Another J Jack runs forward, and I measure Oraudi, and is within 6 inches. Oraudi countercharges and hits him. I roll a critical hit, and he's knocked down and gets some damage, initial damage. So Oraudi up there already means I will be able to do some work there and keep on jamming. So his support staff advances. He gets passage on his jacks, so my assault shots will not work. At least not against the jacks. So the mechanic goes in and repairs the jack. I actually didn't notice he was base to base with the jack, so he went into reach of my lance and then went away, so I could have free strike him, but I did not notice that during the game, just now. So thing to keep on in the future. The bodyguards move into the trench. And Sevi moves into the zone. What I also done wrongly, the counter charge with Oraudi. I had not moved him into the zone. He could have towed the zone a bit after his counter charge move, but I did not pay attention to that, and now Sevi will score. But also I will score with striker, so it will be 1-1 on scenario. So his jack is doing some work, removed one of my lances, and turn goes to me. Oracular Vision is a good ability, but it makes Sevi's jack do less work than they could have, because they always spare some of their focus to remove damages. So my stone blades are now in range of charge, I think from 2 jacks. So I will probably try to do some work with them. I measure the striker can go in a bit, and lancer can go in to be in range of my 2 jacks that are forward, and then lancer will through lancer I will be able to cast positive charge. So positive charge goes on Oraudi and on Firefly that is forward. Junior casts Arcane Shield on Oraudi. Firefly stabs Jack, doing some nice damage. And my, I believe it's a Stormblade Captain, charges in, Weapon Master charge, but unfortunately he used his focus for from Oracular Vision, and the jack forward doesn't have a passage, so my charging storm blades will be able to shoot him and hit him. So also I start shooting. The knockdown jack is an easy target to hit, and he is within range of Firefly, so He gets a lot of damage from shots, and then also a lot of damage from charges, and it's enough to remove him. And the second jack I charged was left on 3 boxes, so nice work, Stoneblades. And then Leather Mode charges, shoots the objective, Electro Leaps bounce around the Roven and Co. And an objective is damaged as well from first the impact, then charge attack, then shoot, then charge attack. And then the second lens does the same, charges in. The leap hits one of the Roven and Co. and then charge attack. Removes the objective, and the lens repositions back. I may need that lens later on. If anybody wonders why my feed token is not out, it's because second round in the row I forgot to feed. So yeah, there is that. Striker did not feed, so I will not have 2 attacks with my forces right now. And well, O'Rowdy goes in, knocks down a bunch of guys, kills one of the bodyguards. And then starts hitting Jack up there, that's in his range. Deals him bunch of damage, but did not kill him. If I, for example, had another move, maybe, then I could have move and finish off those 2 jacks that I started with, that were left just with a couple of boxes. So my lens just hits the jack, but does nothing. And I retreat my 2 of my lenses so I can use them next round. My mechanics just run forward to body block way to striker. And deny the landing space for eventual trample that would get his jack into the zone. So the trample is incoming, he cannot land where he would probably want to, near the zone. But it will go through a few of my Stoneblades. So my opponent thinks about how to deal with this round. I really thought at this moment that not feeding was a disaster, but maybe I can still get out of this. Striker scored, so now I'm 3 with destroyed objects. I'm 3-1, and maybe O'Rowdy will not be so easy to remove from the zone. So my opponent advances his choir. I think he gives out battle to his jacks. And then there's trample going. And my poor Stoneblades gets squashed by his jack. I cannot remember if I mini-fitted with them or not. But nevertheless, I think 2 of them died, 3 of them died. And then the lens blocking the way also died, and he was free to block the zone. So no scoring this round. which is a bit unfortunate. This will make this game a bit longer. So now to have a chance of winning, Striker will have to go in as well, do some work, and so I have to remove those two jacks on the right flank. And in between, my opponent is heavy at work of cleaning his zone. My jack or Audi gets a retaliatory strike on his jack, but roll snake eyes for damage, so there is that. And keep on hitting Oraudi, but so far Oraudi survived. The question is, of course, how long? There is still some weapon master there. So another jack goes in on my Stormblades and removes Captain. So the zone, in the zone is only Oraudi and Leathermaw. Luckily I still have one lens that is back, so even in case if the zone is cleared, Oraudi is gone now. Dervish killed him. So even if the zone will be completely cleared, as you see, I took my token out. Even if the zone would be completely cleared, he would score this round, but I would block him in his round again. So I would be still ahead on scenario. But Leathermaw lived, so the score is still 3-1. And now I pre-measure where Striker would need to be to remove both of those jacks that are trying to go for blocking of my scenario. But first I will try Stormblades. This jack has only 3 boxes left, so this should not be that hard. So Stormblades charge in, assault. Jax received battle, so I can shoot them as well. So it wasn't 3 boxes, it was more like 8 boxes, but with a couple of shots the Jax is dead. So this leaves me Striker. So I get my mechanics blocking his choir. One of them charged but missed, but the rest just ran to block them from going into my zone. And Striker charges in, overpowers on 2 dice, gets I think 6 to strength and 9 damage. And removes, starts hitting the jack and removes him. And then he velocities back and stays on 4 camp. And also I switched Arcane Shield to him, just in case. So this time I have fitted. It would be perfect if I fitted last round, but well, mistakes were made. So Leathermaw hits Sevi and does some damage to him. He's doing so much work that he forgot that he might be in danger. So I continue my jam, my lances just run to keep his jacks busy in his zone, and so he's has problems in moving from the zone. My Stormblade just repositioned, so he has trouble landing in my zone. But because I am low on time, I could not, I could have not pre-measured it very, very exactly. So he might be able to trample. If he removes one or both of my jacks, he might be able to trample into the zone. And that is something he'll probably try to do. So one of his heavies goes and starts pounding at my forces. So my officer is gone. He beats back my Lancer. Lancer is now pretty heavily damaged, but still alive. So Blessing of Vengeance goes, gets hit, but unfortunately I don't destroy his Arc Node. I was like two boxes away from that. And he casts Ashes to Ashes and removes rest of my Stormblades with this. So Striker is now alone and has to kill the Jack that is blocking. So he trampled, I freeze-striked, and that's that. He keeps on cleaning his zone. Luckily, not very successful in this. And then his choir tries to run through my mechanics, but I have a lucky free strike and kill one of his guys that was able to run through. So Striker goes, I heal him for 2, so I can overload on 2 dice. I roll 7 for damage, I think, and 6 for strength. And I start hitting. Charge attack goes in. And he uses Enliven to escape me, but he forgot that Striker is not an easy guy to escape from. I give him free strike and then velocity behind him and kill him with 1 focus to spare. So, a tough battle. Striker by himself removed 2 jacks, and I was able to win this match.
Thank you for watching. I hope.